Happy New Year! Welcome back. Hope you had a joyful break as planned in our pre-Christmas vlog. In which we also talked about Felix and Katja, who do a workshop your life plan. Every year they get together for a couple of days, no kids. You have to put away all distractions. That includes the dog who's pacing around. Even though I have escaped to the end of the garden to think about mine and Chris's workshop for life, because we're going away this weekend.
Please enjoy.
By popular demand, we asked for your feedback. We've got Katja and Felix on the line this week to advise us on how to go about workshopping your life. And the first thing to bear in mind is that you can do this on your own, you can do it as a couple, you can do it with a friend. So this is open to absolutely everyone. If you want a bit of process, Felix will happily send you a beautiful presentation that he's done on how they go about it, but there may be different things that work for you. These are the key things you need to think about. The first one is to get over the vague general awkwardness of this process. Hear what Felix has to say.
I've been workshopping all my life in my work life, and I think it's a completely crazy idea to take a workshop and try and workshop your life. But I think over time, we made it work and we made it less awkward for everyone. At least, you know, it was never awkward for me, but...
It was awkward for me the first time. It definitely was.
We had two kids at the time, and we were both working full time, and we realized that we don't have time and headspace to discuss any of the important issues that exist. So we came home at 9 o'clock or 8 o'clock, cooked dinner, put the kids down, fell to bed. We were always too tired to really talk. So we felt like we need to create some headspace to have all these conversations that we're not having during the year. So we shipped the kids off to in-laws or my parents alternating. And then we just booked ourselves into a hotel for a couple of days to really sleep well, eat well, and have a lot of time and space to talk about all the things that never get talked about, whether it's, should we renovate the house? Should we have a third child? Why is our sex life doing what it does? How should we,
Stop talking about my sex life on LinkedIn. You see her face, it was just like, Jesus, the man has no filter.
And how do we stay healthy? How do we look after the kids that have changing needs all the time? And how do we look after ourselves? What about insurance? Do we need insurance? What about a car? Like all the stupid life admin stuff that is so obnoxious. And if you compress it into a shorter time and you have quality time and you use some process, some workshop techniques, guess what? You actually have meaningful conversations. You actually get resolved. And then you look back and you're like, oh, you just made 12 big decisions. It's like, that's the best feeling ever.
You know, it's like the Marie Kondo for your headspace somehow.
If it feels ridiculous and painful, then it's a better reason to do it, because it means there's something in the closet that could actually help you kind of have a better life.
The second thing is to get your calendar in order. Now, Felix draws his annual calendar. It takes him about 2 hours. I'm afraid we're not that committed, so we printed ours out. But we've already marked in the holidays. We've marked in some key dates, some birthdays, some events. So we're going to work from that as a basis. So once you've got your subjects, you've got your calendar. Now you need to work on some time slots. Felix and Katja work on defined time slots. You might give yourself an hour or 90 minutes to really think about something. And the key here is to have a process that leads you to decisions, because Chris and I great at talking about stuff. Actually calling decisions and writing it down is what really matters here. And a line that Felix used that really registered in my brain is that indecision is expensive. If you don't make a decision about your holidays and you crash into July and then you're trying to book at the last minute, that's an expensive decision. So what can you do to get ahead of yourself? That's important. Then you get to leave with a list of things that you've decided. You've agreed them. You can kind of go into your year ahead knowing that those decisions don't need revisiting. Hooray. And the great outcome, according to Felix and Katja, is that then every other major decision that comes up through the year, you can chuck into a bucket marked for the same meeting in 1 year's time, which means you don't have to have endless conversations unraveling stuff. And I feel like I'm more confident that that's going to work for us than some of the rest of it. Right, we're going to let you know how we get on next week, maybe. I'm going to feedback. But if you do this for yourself, in a group, with a friend, please let us know and let us know what would be on your list. Interested to hear. Next week, Elaine and I are going to be in Zurich meeting some fabulous women business leaders and, you know, being sophisticated in Switzerland. I don't know. What does one do in Zurich? We will also be doing a video on habits. I'm not a big one for New Year's resolutions, but habits is something I think we can all get behind. What makes them stick? What have we learned? Be sharing some of the research into that. And look forward to seeing you then. Take care. We're all going on a summer holiday.